Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, in a relatively short period of time, the Arctic has transformed from a region primarily characterized by isolation, cold and darkness, into a region faced with new challenges, but also buzzing with innovation and opportunities. The Arctic has become a focus point for the international community, attracting attention from all over the world, from scientists and researchers, businesses and industries, international agencies, and non-governmental organizations alike. All are eagerly looking north to see what the future might bring for the Arctic, as development and environmental changes in the region will affect not only the Arctic populations, but a much bigger community worldwide. We Icelanders like to believe that we enjoy a special position in the Arctic, being the one member state of the Arctic Council that is situated entirely within the boundaries of the region. Arctic affairs touch upon almost all aspects of Icelandic society. Therefore, we look forward to take over the chairmanship of the Arctic Council from Finland in May next year and to hold that responsibility until Russia takes over 2 years later. The Arctic warms at a more than twice the global rate, and Arctic warming trends are expected to continue towards mid-century. Scientists tell us that trends after 2050 will depend on today's mitigation actions. The latest report from the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change spells out very clearly that there is no way to mitigate climate change without taking drastic actions. Addressing climate and environmental issue is therefore of utmost importance for governments of the Arctic states. In the spirit of the Ottawa Declaration that founded the Arctic Council 22 years ago, sustainable development will be the guiding light in our chairmanship program. Sustainable development can be compared to a three-leaved clover because social, environmental, and economic sustainability must go together. That is why we must strive for economic prosperity and social well-being in a strong and healthy Arctic environment. Most inhabitants in the Arctic region live in close proximity to nature and must deal with challenging environmental conditions. This is our reality in Iceland. We rely extensively on the nature of our country for our livelihood, be it fishing, tourism, energy production, or agriculture. With sustainable development as our guiding principle, we have built a prosperous society. Through the rich and diverse cultures that the circumpolar Arctic region harbors, together we can build thriving sustainable societies for all based on knowledge sharing, innovation, and hard work. Last month, Iceland presented a draft plan for its upcoming chairmanship of the Arctic Council. We will be further developing the plan with our Arctic Council partners over the next few months, but I believe that I can share with you our broader points of departure. First, I would like to mention the Arctic marine environment. As you know, the Arctic region consists largely of oceans, and it should not come as a surprise to anyone, given Iceland's geographic location, that the oceans will figure at the top of our agenda. The largest part of the Arctic region is covered by ocean, and the welfare of a large part of the population in the Arctic is based on the utilization of marine resources. The Arctic Council working groups have carried out many important ocean-related projects, and Iceland will focus on continuation and further development of projects in that field. Iceland is particularly interested in strengthening Arctic Council cooperation on mitigating plastic pollution of the oceans, and is planning an international scientific conference on the topic in Reykjavik, Iceland, in April 2020. Iceland is also hoping to introduce a new project focusing on innovation and efficient utilization of marine biological resources, or the so-called blue bioeconomy. The second priority I would like to mention is climate and green energy solutions. We will be continuing the emphasis of Finland on meteorological cooperation, and I would in particular like to mention a project on mapping glaciers using a digital elevation method developed under the US chairmanship and providing a much more accurate information on the dramatic glacial reduction being witnessed in my part of the world. The impending shift in energy sources from fossil fuels to renewable energy will be important, both for reducing greenhouse gas emissions and for improving air quality in communities in the Arctic. Iceland aims to further work for further work to be carried out based on the ARENA project and to continue to seek practical green energy solutions for small communities in the Arctic. Our third main substantive priority will be on the people of the Arctic and their desire to build prosperous yet sustainable communities. The Arctic Council has a strong history of promoting sustainable development and growth in communities in the region, and we have ambition to continue cooperation on matters like gender equality, connectivity, and adaptation and resilience. It is evident that in the coming decades, adapting to continuous warming of the Arctic will be a major challenge for many of the small Arctic communities, not least the indigenous people. Last but not least, Iceland will continue to work for a better and stronger Arctic Council. The Arctic Economic Council will celebrate its 5 years anniversary during Iceland's chairmanship, and it would be very fitting to seize that opportunity to enhance the collaboration between the two councils. We will also give due attention to the inner workings of the Arctic Council by maintaining the close consultations between member states and the permanent participants, and continue to use innovative ways to engage with observers in an enhanced manner. It is of the utmost importance for both prosperity and security in the Arctic region to work closely with partners outside the region. The Arctic Council has been an important venue for political dialogue and peaceful cooperation in the Arctic region. The Council's clear mandate, with its regional focus on sustainable development in the Arctic, has allowed it to continue its work, irrespective of global political tensions. It is not least for this reason that the Arctic Council has such an important role to play and that Iceland attaches such great emphasis to continued good cooperation on the Council. Ladies and gentlemen, interesting and challenging tasks lie ahead of us, and let me assure you that I am optimistic for the future of the Arctic region. If I were to choose only a few words that carry the most significance for the region's well-being in the future, it would be peace and stability on one hand and sustainable development on the other hand. In Iceland's view, we have not only the interest but also the tools and the means to continue to work together for a sustainable and prosperous Arctic region. Thank you.